Welcome to the Blitz replay package, 9 race program. Let's get straight into the first race, 1200 meters, all the races on the poly track. In the first race, number 1, Anti Omnia. He'd corner back in third position, black sleeves and cap. He'd come through to win. Just looking at the starter, he reported Imagination was restless in the stalls and stumbled, leaving the stalls, losing 2 lengths. Catnip returned post-race having cast both 4 shoes, and the veterinary surgeon reported Imagination, Epistaxis, Catnip, abnormal respiratory noises, and Speedy Cut.
Nashira's running on. Wilbur's on the inside. Anti Omnia. Nashira's trying to get into the race late, but it's Anti Omnia now hit the front at the right time. And Anti Omnia's going to go and win it. Second will go to Ajira. Wilbur and third, maybe Too Cool fourth, in Roy's Amazing Ash.
That was the start for the Dennis Dreyer stable. On to race number 2, once again 1200 meters. In the second race, number 7, Miss Parker would come home to win it. Watch this run from the first time, and number 10, Soldier's Bride, would come from second to last with the bright yellow cap and blue sleeves. At approximately the 1,000-meter mark, Taffeta shifted in slightly, resulting in Cherry Hill and Hallucination having to be eased, and Disrupt switched out off the inside running rail, carrying Soldier's Bride outwards at approximately 800-meter mark.
Cherry Hill still the leader. Hungry Arch trying to close it down. Miss Parker's down the inside. It's Cherry Hill just the leader. Miss Parker's the danger. Hungry Heart. Cherry Hill, Hungry Heart at a check. But now Miss Parker comes into the lead. And yes, Soldier's Bride taking off late. But it goes to Miss Parker from Soldier's Bride. Maybe Cherry Hill third.
Next up, race number 3, they'd step over distance. It would be over 1,900 metres. Number 1, Deputy Judd would find most of the market support. He was up in second, turning for home, but watch to the inside. Number 7, Kitty's Destiny, cornered in third. He'd come through to take the victory laurels. Kenny Gayo, that's the runner who faded out late on and would be reported as fatigued.
Ethic Storm Eclipse comes out for a run. Deputy Judd just the leader, and Kitty's Destiny is making a big race of it. Deputy Judd and Kitty's Destiny, these are the 2 Storm Eclipse on the outside. Kitty's Destiny, Deputy Judd, Storm Eclipse on the outside. Kitty's Destiny though goes on, and Kitty's Destiny has won it. Deputy Judd second, French Revolution third, Storm Eclipse fourth.
Race number 4 would be the opening leg of the Pick 6. That'd go over 1,900 metres. Plenty of support would come in for number 2, Starrett City. Starrett City back in third with Anthony Del Pesh, those red and white silks. He would come gliding through for a very good victory. The runner that faded out late on was Old Equalizer, and the veterinary surgeon reported that he was lame left-hand.
Starrett City comes forward now with the white cap. Cali's King, Silver Sage, Cousine sprints. But at Starrett City past the 200-meter mark has gone clear of the opposition. Cousine sprints tries to run on in Cali's King, but Starrett City's going on. Here's Silver Sage with a late run, but Starrett City's going on to win it. Starrett City will win it. Second, Silver Sage. The third place, Cali's King, and fourth, Mehmed.
Race number 5 would have that very open look about it, but number 2, Go Direct. He'd go directly to the front, and then he'd be past it around the 1,000-meter mark, and that's when Tangiero took a hold, and just reporting here from the Stipendary stewards, Tangiero over-raced in the early stages, and as a result of the slow pace, improved his position and raced to the front, approaching the 1,000-meter mark.
Pure Valor, Texican, Delirious Nomad goes in for a run. The Ginger Man's on the outside, then Petite Master. Go Direct now comes at Tangiero, Pure Valor. Texican's on the inside, then Delirious Nomad. But it's still Go Direct past the 200-meter marker. And Go Direct is running strongly. Go Direct will win. Second will go to Pure Valor. Third place, maybe Texican or Delirious Nomad.
Victory full of merit for number 2, Go Direct. Race number 6, number 1, Ferry. He'd be the horse that the punters went for. They'd back him down to favourite. out in front, he'd hang towards the outside of the course, but he'd be full of running with 300 metres left to go. Veterinary surgeon reported Natatella cut into left four and also coughing.
Spring Wonder on the inside, then Top Form. Our Destiny down the inside, Fabergé style. Ferry still being kept together, and Seattle Lady's now going to throw out the challenge. Our Destiny's running on the inside. Ferry's still the leader. Our Destiny is closing it down, and then Seattle Lady, but Ferry goes on, and Ferry's going on to win it. Our Destiny will come out second, then Seattle Lady and Top Form.
No feedback for the remaining races as we go straight into race number 7. This was over 1600 meters. Very, very open looking affair. Royal Tree out in front with the blue blinkers on. That would be the horse to catch. Coming to the last 200 meters, Coastal Spell in the orange and yellow silks towards the inside. She'd start to pour on the pressure.
Down the inside with Coastal Spell. Takazi the leader, Royal Tree. Coastal Spell, Mission Rapids on the outside, sounds positive. Coastal Spell on the inside, River Course, sounds positive. Madame Lara, but it's Coastal Spell the leader, sounds positive. River Course, the Morrigan's running on the inside, but Coastal Spell, River Course on the outside, sounds positive, but it's Coastal Spell. Coastal Spell won it. River Course second, the Morrigan third, close for fourth.
Next up would be race number 8, the penultimate race of the afternoon. Number 3, Music World from the Belinda MP stable and Anthony Del Pesh. They'd corner with about 4 lengths to make up at the rail in about 6th position and would just go on for a cozy victory.
Then Music World, La Carmelita's on the outside, then Deep Down Rebel. They're followed further back by Bold Star. Coming to the 300-meter marker, Just Smoker, Music World. On the outside, Villa Floriana, Queen of Credit, Tigress Dance as a runner. And it's Music World, though, the one to beat past the 200-meter marker. Tigress Dance, Villa Floriana, behind that one, Judge Express. But Music World's going on, and Music World will win it. Second place will go to its close, Tigress Dance or Terapova, and then Judge Express.
One race left on the cards, that would be race number 9, over 1600 metres. This would produce one of the more exciting finishes of the day. Number 12, Silver Rose, from about 4th last on the right-hand side, would really come diving through. Smart World in the orange and black silk has been ridden for all he's worth, and they'd fight it out, but number 12, Silver Rose, he'd get the gold on the post.
Come to the last 300, open answer. Leonard is down the inside, Maneuver comes out for a run. Then Smart World, Georgie Boy down the inside, Street Boy, Gold Sail on the outside, running on a Silver Rose. But it's open answer on the inside, hit the front, Leonard's fighting back. Maneuver and on the outside, Silver Rose, Smart World, they get to the line. I think Silver Rose won it from Smart World. Close for third, it changed dramatically the last 25.
That's a wrap for our Greyville midweek meeting. We'll catch you on Saturday. Daily News 2000 Day. Big racing ahead of us. We'll catch you then.